Hi, I'm Colonel Marc Lachapelle, Commander 22 Wing, Canadian Forces North Bay. Je suis ici avec l'adjudant-chef Debbie Martins, et nous célébrons la Journée des Forces Armées. As you can imagine this year, we cannot have groups of people gather for those demonstrations that we like to normally bring you, such as the Snowbirds, the Skyhawks, and the Demo F-18. So this year, we're going virtual.
Hello, bonjour, Annie. This is Anthony Rota, Member of Parliament for Nipissing, Temiskaming, and Speaker of the House of Commons. Today is Armed Forces Day. This annual event is an opportunity to celebrate the important relationship between our city's military and civilian communities. And even though we can't celebrate in person, it is wonderful to still be a part of this event virtually. We are not going to let COVID get in the way of us thanking the men and women of the Canadian Armed Forces. We truly appreciate the sacrifices you make to keep our country safe. Nous apprécions les sacrifices que vous faites pour assurer la sécurité de notre pays. As well, we continue to recognize the true spirit of friendship and cooperation that exists between Canada and the United States of America. Our next door neighbor has been, is, and will continue to be our closest friend and ally. I would like to offer a salute to all serving military members of North Bay, to the families who stand behind them, and all of us who proudly stand behind all of you. J'aimerais rendre hommage à tous les militaires à North Bay, aux familles qui les appuient, et à tous ceux d'entre nous qui vous appuient fièrement. Thank you. Merci. Miigwech.
Today is a day to say thank you to our brave men and women of the armed forces. This day serves as a reminder of the freedoms we have. You fine men and women leave safety behind, leave your families behind, and head to places many of us have never heard. Thank you for doing this. We enjoy freedom and a sense of pride in the Canadian Forces for leading the way into both battle and into peacekeeping missions. You have our respect, and you have the respect of nations around the world. You've earned it. Thank you for continuing to put your country first.
Hello, everyone. It is my great pleasure to bring greetings on behalf of the City of North Bay and to declare today Armed Forces Appreciation Day in our city. Something that we're very proud of is we have the largest Armed Forces Appreciation Day right across the country. That's how much we support our women and men that have served our country, that are serving our country, and lost their lives serving their country so that we could have our freedoms and liberties protected. I am proud that my dad served for over 28 years in the armed forces, and it's something that our whole family cherishes, that you know, we had a family member that served. So please take this day to thank the women and men that do keep us safe day in and day out. They never get the recognition that they deserve, and come out, although virtually this year, to support Armed Forces Appreciation Day.
As you can imagine, our mission here at North Bay is complex, and it takes some of the best people in the world to do that mission. Let me take this time to introduce them to you.
Hi, my name is Aviator Mina Shahata. I'm a cook. I'm originally from Cairo, Egypt. A lot of difference between North Bay and Cairo. My first winter, we was so exciting about to see the snow, like we never saw snow in Egypt. Right after I joined the Canadian Armed Forces, first thing they send us to do like basic training in St. John's Sur Richelieu in Montreal. First 2-3 weeks, very hard for me. For my age, I joined as like 38 years old. I said, well, I take the challenge, and I did it. Best time ever, but I don't want to do it again. What I like about to work in the kitchen as a cook, like I like the teamwork, I like the environment in the kitchen, like everybody help each other, learn something new every day, new recipe every day. We love to feed the people, our customer, and make them happy. Obviously, the pandemic changed everything in the kitchen here, so we still feeding the people every day. So instead, they sitting here in the dining room, so they come and pick up the food. My name is Aviator Mina Shahata, and I am 22 Wing.
I am Corporal Annie Cox. I am from Halifax, Nova Scotia. Today we are in 51 Squadron. We are currently in the training center that we use to prepare candidates to work in 21 Squadron supporting the NORAD mission. Basic training was an experience I will never forget. I made a lot of friendships there that I would have never made otherwise. It really brought me out of my bubble, which in turn, I built a lot of confidence. Something that surprised me about the Canadian Armed Forces was the diversity in trade and trade training. Specifically in my trade, aerospace control operator, I joined to do air traffic control. However, upon arriving at 22 Wing, I found out that we can do NORAD, which is air defense, we can do space operations, we can do tactical data link, and we can do flying. We can also go to flying squadrons. My job as an instructor is to prepare members for real-world situations, including CF-18 intercepts and surveillance of Canadian airspace. Due to the bi-national agreement, we work with about 30 Americans here at 22 Wing. My experience so far has been great, learning their tactics, their techniques, their procedures, their culture. They bring different personality here, which is very exciting. My name is Corporal Annie Cox, and I am 22 Wing.
I'm Captain Chris Johnson. I'm an aerospace control officer, and here at 21 Aerospace Control and Warning Squadron, I'm a senior director, and I'm from Montreal, Quebec. So my trade is an aerospace control officer, and what that means is that I am involved directly with controlling aircraft. Now, there are multiple branches for aerospace control officer. You have the air traffic control side, where you get VFR or IFR. VFR is visual flight rules, IFR is instrument flight rules, so you're working either in the tower or you're working in terminal. Think Nav Canada and typical air traffic control that you would hear about. In my case, I am an air battle manager. I am focused more on air defense as opposed to air traffic control. So whereas air traffic control moves planes away from each other and tries to keep planes separate, my job is to bring planes together. And we work directly with the fighter squadrons at Bagotville and Cold Lake. And it is our job to protect the skies of North America. And if there are any hijacked aircraft, if there are any aircraft that are experiencing emergencies that are requiring and requesting military assistance, we will scramble the fighters out of those two bases and go and intercept, and that thus bringing aircraft together. Also, what I think most Canadians don't necessarily realize about NORAD is, and Canada's role in NORAD, is that it's a 24/7 operation. During the weekends, during holidays, Christmas, New Year's. And we are always watching the skies. We are here to watch and protect Canada and the United States. My name is Captain Chris Indy Johnston, and I am 22 Wing.
Hello, my name is Staff Sergeant Thomas Strong. I am 30 years old and was born and raised in Wichita, Kansas. The reason why I joined the United States Air Force is because it was an opportunity to get out of my shell out of Wichita and to travel the world. My job here at 22 Wing Operations Support Squadron is to provide simulated amalgam arrows, fabric gains to the crews that are working operationally, and to provide a real world simulated action to them so they can make decisions on the fly and simulate it and make those mistakes on the fly and learn from them so that when it comes to real world live fly, they don't have to make those mistakes. What has impressed me about the Canadians working with them is that how prideful they are at what they do and being a Canadian. And that's why bringing that bi-national agreement, not only that as a proud US, they are proud Canadians, and there's nothing more than I like to work alongside them. And it's 12 hour days. They may be long, but we are monitoring a 24 hour system over the North Warning System and Canada alone. And with that, working at night have its perks, but it also has its down as we're working 12 hours from 7 to 7. It's funny about the small differences between US and Canada is when you see ketchup chips, you're like, that's kind of weird. But until you had it, it's crazy. It's so good. But until you get introduced to new chips such as Alldress, man, that's a game changer. Canada has M&Ms, but in Canada they're called Smarties. But in the US, Smarties is completely different. But your guys' Smarties is our M&Ms, and our Smarties is something else for you guys. So it's really weird that the correlation between the two when I first learned about Smarties in Canada. My name is Staff Sergeant Thomas Strong, and I am 22 Wing.
In addition, we also have dental, administration, official languages, military police, religious services, photography, personal support programs, finance, supply, and safety, just to name a few.
We would also like to extend a huge thank you to the sponsors from the local community that come together every year to make these events happen. It goes without saying, but it couldn't happen without you.
Hopefully we're able to bring the 22-wing mission to you. Next year, we really hope that we'll be able to have an in-person Armed Forces Day with all the demonstrations that you truly love. If you're interested in joining the Canadian Armed Forces, please reach out to us. I'm Colonel Mark LaChapelle.
And I'm Chief Warrant Officer Debbie Martins.
And we are 22 Wing.